All right, this chapter we're going to spend literally 2 days on today, and well, 3 days. Today, Friday's a C day, right? Today, Friday, Monday, and test next Wednesday, quiz next Wednesday, whatever. So we're not going to spend much time on it. Probability, we've seen this before, but because it's on the ACT test and other college tests, we need to keep hitting on it just so you know what you're doing with probability. Sample spaces, probability functions, Venn diagrams, G diagrams, all that fun stuff. Probability is the number of favorable outcomes over the total number of outcomes. Okay? The number of outcomes that we're talking about over the total number of outcomes. Okay? The probability that it's going to snow tomorrow might be 13%. So out of 100 chances, there are 13 chances it will snow. So then the complement of that event would be there is an 87% chance that it will not snow. Okay? Those are called the complement of an event. Okay, you roll two die. Okay? So you hit ones on each, they add up to two. Okay, you got a 1 out of 36 chance of rolling snake eyes. Okay, you have two chances of rolling three because a 1 on the left dice and a 1 on the right dice, or a 2 on the right dice, or a 2 on the left dice and a 1 on the right dice, and so on. Okay, so chances of rolling a 4, there's 3 of them. A 1 and a 3, a 2 and a 2, and a 3 and a 1, and so on. Okay, all the way down. So you get chances bigger, all the way up to here, and then they start dropping again. Okay, so probability for rolling the sum of a dice. So find the probability of rolling a sum of 4 on a single roll of 2 fair dice. So if we go back to this one, rolling a 4 would be 3 out of 36, which would reduce down to a 1 out of 12 chance of rolling a 4. Okay. Ooh. Oh, a sum divisible by 4. I didn't read it. I was doing a 4. So you got a 3 out of 36 chance of rolling a 4, a 5 out of 36 chance of rolling an 8, and a 1 out of 36 chance of rolling a 12. Add them up, 9 out of 36 chance. A quarter of the time, you're going to roll a sum divisible by 4. Okay? Make sure you read the problem instead of thinking you know what the problem is. The probability of function assigns a real number to it, and the probability will always be between 0 and 1. Okay? So, if it happens in all outcomes, it's a 1. If it doesn't happen, it's a 0. All right, choosing chocolates. Dylan opens a box of chocolates and offers 3 of them to Russell. Russell likes vanilla the best, but all the chocolates look alike on the outside. If 5 of the 12 creams are vanilla, what's the probability that all of Russell's are vanilla? All right. So he picks out how many of them? 3 of them. So the first pick, he's got a 5 in 12 chance of it being vanilla. Okay. His second pick of a cream, if it's vanilla, then he's got a 4 out of 11 chance of getting a vanilla. Okay. And then if that one's vanilla, then he's got a 3 out of 10 chance of the third one being vanilla. Okay. Oh, they're doing it that way. Okay. So they got 1 out of 22. See if we get 1 out of 22. 3 goes into 12, 1 and 4 times. four cancels with four. Five goes into 10, one and two times. So I get 1 out of 22. Okay. Same thing as what they got. Except for what they did is they used a combination. Okay. They used a combination. 3 out of 12 and 3 out of 5 combination. But I kind of like the way I did multiplication principle. Okay. Conditional probabilities. Given that you have A, what's the probability of B happening? Given A is happening, what is the probability of then B happening? Okay. We'll see some of those. Come on. Out. Discard. Okay. So let's look on this. Did I screw that up? I thought I had. Nope. That's AP Calc. Pre-Calc. New section 10. 10-1. There we go. All right. A pair of die are rolled. What's the probability of getting an 8? Well, an 8 consists of a 1 and a 7. Is there such a thing as a 7 on a die? No. So it'd be a 2 and a 6, a 3 and a 5, a 4 and a 4, a 5 and a 3, or a 6 and 2. So there are 5 chances out of the 36 total chances of getting an 8. Okay? 5 out of 36. Because there's 6 times 6 chances. 6 in each die. Okay? Find the probability of getting a sum less than 8. Okay? A sum less than 8. Well, a 1 and a 1 is less than 8. A 1 and a 2 and a 2 and a 1 is less than 8. A 1 and a 3, a 2 and a 2, and a 3 and a 1 is less than 8. A 1 and a 4, a 2 and a 3, a 3 and a 2, and a 4 and a 1 is less than 8. A 1 and a 5, a 2 and a 4, a 3 and a 3, a 4 and a 2, and a 5 and a 1 is less than 8. A 1 and a 6, 2 and 5, 3 and 4, 4 and 3, 5 and 2, 6 and 1 are all less than 8. Okay? And then we get to the 8s. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So I got a 21 out of the 36 total chances. Okay. And if we reduce them down, that's 7 out of 12. Divide them both by 3. A single die is rolled twice. Find the probability of getting two numbers whose sum is 5 or 2. Okay. Now a single die is rolled twice. Find the probability of getting a 5 or a 2. When you see or, you add the two probabilities together. If you see the word and, you multiply them together. Or is addition and is multiplication. So what's the probability of getting two numbers whose sum is 5? Well, you got 1, 2, 3, 4. A 4 out of 36 chance of getting a 5. Chances of getting a 2 are a 1 out of 36. So you add them together and get 5 out of 36. That's the probability of getting a 5 or a 2 when you roll 2 die. Let's see if that was right. I might have to add on to that. 5 out of 36. Nope, that's right. All right. The maker of a candy that comes in colors like M&M's 20% are blue, 10% are red, 10% are white, 20% are green, 10% are pink, 3% are tan. And you're going, tan? Well, back when I was growing up, they didn't have red M&Ms. Okay? They had tan M&Ms instead of red M&Ms. And they didn't have pink either. But they had tan because they thought the red dye caused cancer. So then they switched out the dye. And now they have red ones again. Okay? But they figured red dye caused cancer. So then they didn't have red M&Ms. Amazing story. All right. But then they got rid of the tan ones because tan was boring. So a single candy is drawn at random. What's the probability that it's tan or red? Since it's or, we add them together. Tan, red. So it should be 0.04. The maker of candy, what's the probability that it's blue? 0.3. Okay. And so on. Red, neither red nor white. So you find red and white, which is 50%. So not red and white would be the other 50%. Neither red nor white. Okay, that's the same as last one. Suppose our four cards are drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. What's the probability that all four are diamond? So you go a diamond and a diamond and a diamond and a diamond. So since it's and, you multiply. So you got a 13 out of 52 chance, because there's 13 diamonds, because 1/4 of them are diamonds. 13 diamonds out of 52 times 12 out of 51, because the first one's a diamond, then you got 12 chances of being diamond out of the 51 left, times 11 out of 50 times 10 out of 49. And just multiply those to figure out if it works. Now, this number, your graphing calculator can handle fairly easily. Sometimes they say if like 9 cards and it's really long and it gets to be a crazy number. Okay. If it snows tomorrow, the probability is 90% that John will practice his piano. If it does not snow, there's only a 40% chance that he will practice. Let's suppose the chance of snow tomorrow is 60%. Well, if there's a 60% chance of snow, then there's a 90% chance he'll practice the piano, which is 54%. There's a 40% chance it won't snow, which will give him only a 40% chance of practicing his piano, which is 16%. Then you add them together and you get there's a 70% chance of him practicing piano tomorrow. Okay. Last one. An executive committee consists of 9 members, 5 men, 4 women. If 3 are selected at random to go to Hawaii and the names are drawn from a hat, what's the probability that all 3 are women? Okay. So you've got a 4 out of 9 chance for the first one. What's the second one going to be? 3 out of 8, third one. 2 out of 7. 3 and 9 cancel be 1 and 3. 4 and 8 cancel be 1 and 2. 2 and 2 cancel to be 1. So it's 1 out of a 21 shot that all 3 of them are women. 1 out of 21. Okay, so I will put the assignment out there. It shouldn't be too bad for you to complete. And then Friday we'll do another assignment. And then Monday we'll do another assignment. And the practice test or practice quiz. And then Wednesday